Welcome to Python with Andrew. And we're going to continue our discussion on functions. If you want to brush up on the basics, there's a few videos on the basics. And I'm also going to use a dictionary. So if you're not too sure about dictionaries, then do brush up on those videos and have a look at the videos on dictionaries. They're both very simple to use. And I'm going to assume that you've seen those videos or you know a little bit about using dictionaries or functions. So I'm going to take an inventory, a very, very basic inventory, and I'm going to add some commands to that inventory. But the way I'm going to do it is I'm going to write a function for each command. So let's see how we go with that. We jump over. Let's have a look at the code. So at the moment, all I've got is the data structure, inventory, and I use this one because it's my favorite aisle in the supermarket. It's got chips and chocolate and Coke and popcorn. And with each item, it's got the quantity. So we want to provide commands in our, if you like, program to return the amount of a particular inventory item, add a new inventory item, and then print out the dictionary in whole. So let's do that as functions. So the first one I want to do is define get amount. And I'm going to take in a name, which is the name of the item. I'm going to call it an item, actually. Let's call it an item. Okay. And the first thing I'm going to do is write a short document, a short bit of documentation, just so we start getting to the habit of documenting every function we have. So return the amount for this item. And so this is simply going to return the inventory of the item. Nothing special about that. Now, I am using that inventory as a global variable. If you remember back to a previous video, everything inside here is local, but this is a global variable. At this stage, I'm going to use it. I could improve this by actually passing the inventory into the function as another parameter, but I'm just going to do that. And I'm going to define another one called add item. In this case, it's going to take an item and an amount. It's going to take two variables, two arguments, and we're going to refer to that. So let's add this item to the inventory. Okay, and it's simply going to go inventory item inventory item equals amount. And it's not going to return anything. So this function doesn't return anything. It just adds an item to the inventory. And the last one we're going to do is print and this one's going to take no arguments and it's going to print the inventory. So of course I'm writing very, very basic functions. I'm doing very, very small bits of code, but you see what I'm trying to do is I'm going to try for every command we need to do, I'm going to do a function. And this is for item in inventory, print inventory item and inventory item. All right. Now I should print that out nicer, but I'm not going to. I'm not going to do that for this particular code because otherwise you'll just be watching me type. So they're my three functions. Now, if this was a bigger program and a bit different user interface, maybe the commands are done differently. And we could ask the user the commands and all that sort of stuff. But I'm not going to do that. I'm going to do it as if we were writing it inside this function. So the first thing I want to do is I'm going to print get mount for chips. Get mount chip, open brackets, chips. All right. So hopefully if I have done this correctly, this all should work. Let's see how I go. Fingers crossed. It does. It gives me the answer 10 back. So fingers crossed. Very simple programs. Very easy for me to write them. Then next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to add a new item. Well, actually, no, let's print the inventory and see what that does now. So then it does all of them, which is great. And let me now add an item into our dictionary. And this time we're going to add some lollies. We call them lollies here in Australia. And there's going to be 23 of them, or they're sweets, whatever you're used to calling them. Now, of course, that doesn't return anything. It doesn't print anything. It just adds those. So we need to print it after again. See if we add lollies. Let's see if that works afterwards. Okay, so let me clear that. And if I print that out, you can see that the first time through, we had chips, chocolate, popcorn. The second time we've added an item, lollies, this one down the bottom here. So it works, which is great. So you could imagine that I could make this program down the bottom here, depending on what the user put in, add this item or print out the inventory or whatever command the user gave us, whether they typed it in or they clicked a button, that's a different process altogether. But at the moment, my program has three short, sharp functions. They're very, very simple to understand. And they're the best use of functions. When they're small, they've got a one line or so of documentation. And they do one or two small things, right? This only the bottom one does a loop, but the rest are just simply either doing one thing or returning one thing. And you can see I've got a mixture. One returns, one just adds, one has two arguments, one has none arguments. So all sorts of different uses of functions in a very, very simple way. Okay, so what I recommend is if you have the chance, try and work on this program and make this bottom bit a bit more. So maybe you have another function that asks for the input from the user. Maybe you have another function that does something maybe different from this, maybe deletes an item from the inventory or checks if items are below or hit zero. So we have to order more. So we can add more functions to this. Okay, so that'll work for you to do. Let me know how you go in the comments. It'd be good to hear. And also let me know if you've got any questions about this or other particular code you'd like to see. I'm going to do a few series of this where I take some basic functions and we just get into the habit of writing small, short, sharp functions. But that's all for today. I hope you have a great day and enjoy.